Portfolio construction groups at fund managers are growing in importance and prevalence as firms see the value in deepening relationships with advisors. With more advisors being open to receiving a portfolio consultation from a fund company, it's another way for firms to expand beyond the product-focused sale. I'm Pat Newcomb with Fuse Research, and today we're going to take a few minutes to discuss findings from our Advisor Trend Monitor report, Portfolio Construction, the Advisor View, covering the receptivity of advisors for this type of advice and the success rate once advisors meet with a portfolio construction specialist. In a recent survey conducted by Fuse Research and wealthmanagement.com, more than 600 advisors were asked if they had recently received advice from a portfolio construction specialist at a fund manager. Just shy of a quarter of advisors, or 24%, had recently met with a specialist, and 47% said they'd been contacted but weren't interested. The remaining responses were predominantly made up of advisors that didn't meet the minimum asset level required for a consultation. Interestingly, as an advisor's book size increases, the percentage of advisors taking these meetings also increased, going from 20% of advisors with less than $50 million in assets to nearly 30% of advisors with $150 million or more in assets. In order to understand the success rate of these meetings, we asked advisors not only if they took the meeting, but what the end result was. Overall, 71% of advisors surveyed were actually contacted by a fund manager for portfolio construction advice. This was significantly higher at the wirehouse firms, with 87% of advisors being contacted, compared to only 59% of RIAs surveyed. This is most likely driven by the fact that managers have a much better understanding of and greater focus on their wirehouse prospects. Once an advisor is contacted by a fund manager, roughly one-third of advisors actually took the meeting. This was very consistent across distribution channels, with the main exception being RIAs, who took these meetings at a slightly lower rate of 28%. For advisors that ended up taking the meeting with a portfolio construction specialist, the success rate was strong. Overall, 37% of advisors that met with a portfolio construction specialist said that it resulted in a product sale with that manager. This was the highest in the wirehouse channel, with a 43% success rate. IBD advisors were next with 34%, and RIAs had the lowest with 25%. From an age perspective, younger advisors were most likely to purchase a fund from the firm after meeting with the specialist, 43% success for advisors under the age of 45, compared to 30% for advisors age 60 or older. From the fund manager's perspective, although the goal is for these meetings to lead to a product sale, having a meeting without a sale should serve to build and strengthen the relationship. Ultimately, the success rate of these meetings is going to be driven by the amount and quality of intel that a fund firm has about each individual advisor, regardless of channel, book size, or practice type. This all starts with getting to know the advisor, their practice, and their process. From there, firms must leverage technology to measure engagement and determine the best candidates for a portfolio construction consultation. Thank you for taking the time to view this video. If you have any questions about the topic we covered today, or would like to learn more about other topics that are included in our Portfolio Construction, the Advisor View 2019 ATM report, please let us know. Thanks again, and have a great day.